Hello, my name is Jeanette Carr. I'm with the World Health Organization Radiation and Health Program in Geneva, Switzerland. Dear colleagues, dear friends, it is my great pleasure to deliver on behalf of the World Health Organization the greetings and this official speech today on the occasion of the opening of the new training center for radiation emergency medical training in Nagasaki. This event is an important development in further strengthening the national medical preparedness to nuclear emergencies in Japan. But in addition to that, it is also a very important event at the regional and the global level, the global scale, because Nagasaki University is providing training and education for the specialists and students from around the world. In achieving its goals under the Global Program of Work, JPW number 13, the World Health Organization is aiming at saving lives and improving health of 3 billion people. One of these billions is due to strategic objective, strategic aim of helping WHO member states to be better prepared to all hazards and all types of health emergencies, including radiological and nuclear emergencies. In implementing its mandate, WHO works in partnerships with other international organizations, with NGOs, with professional societies, with national health authorities and academia. Through the system of WHO collaborating centers, supporting our technical work in countries and at a global level, our organization delivers its ambitious targets for strengthening the global health security. More specifically, in the area of radiation emergencies, WHO has established a global expert network, RAMPAN, where Nagasaki University is one of the most active and most supportive members. The history of our collaboration and friendship goes way back to the times of post-Chernobyl accident. And since 1994, the Atomic Bomb Disease Institute of the Nagasaki University has been officially designated as a WHO collaborating center and a member of RAMPAN network. In 2004-2006, we had the pleasure and an honor of having Professor Shunichi Yamashita joining the radiation program of the WHO in Geneva, Switzerland. The beautiful cherry trees, which really enlighten WHO premises every spring, are actually appeared there thanks to Professor Yamashita's initiative, who organized and facilitated together with the permanent mission of Japan to the UN organizations in Geneva, the donation of this beautiful cherry alley. Many, many thanks and great appreciation. I also would like to thank personally Professor Noboru Takamura for his tireless support and all his team, all the staff of the Nagasaki University for the tireless efforts for education, training, and research in the area of radiation emergency preparedness, response and recovery, and radiation epidemiology, radiopathology, and risk communication as well. The expertise of the specialists was applied in full and is being applied for mitigation of health consequences of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant accident. We, of course, hope that such accident will never happen again, but we still have to be prepared. This is the only way to be safe. Once again, congratulations, heartfelt congratulations to all of you on the occasion of the opening of this new beautiful facility. I look forward to continue our fruitful collaboration and hopefully to have an opportunity to visit this new center in the near future. Thank you so much, and all the best to all of you. Thank you.